try it again. Let's try from the top. Let's try it from the top. Yeah. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am tonight's entertainment. It's been a week. It's been 7 days. I've waited 7 days for you. I've craved you. Oh, I've missed you. Well, guys, well, how's everyone's weekend? How's everyone's weekend? A lot of little Friendsgiving is going around. Speaking of Friendsgiving, that's what this weekly shit plug podcast episode is about. Episode 10, I think we are on. I think this is 10. Last week was 9. The week before that was 8, I think. And yes, I'm getting a little too old to count, but yes, this will be 10. And for our 10th episode, this will be a quick one. I know I say it's a quick one all the time, and it ends up being like 30, 40 minutes, but this one will be a quick one. This is a recap of my Friendsgiving and a little bit of future stuff and what everyone wants to see and this and that and this and that and one and one and one. So, my first time, I hosted a Friendsgiving this past Saturday, and I was a little skeptical and scared because I've never done this before. I don't even think I've been to a Friendsgiving. I think maybe I have, but I don't know. Anyways, this is the first time I was the host of one. I even sat with my friends, try to get, like, who's cooking what, this, that, the other. I was in charge of turkey and macaroni and cheese and a home to provide the stuff in. And everyone was in charge of either drinks, food, whatever, mostly food. And it turned out to be fucking good. And I'm not a huge turkey fan, so if they liked it, then they liked it. Which everyone, people were saying they liked the turkey. I'm going to go down the list. Daisy was in charge of rice. The arroz con gandules, which was fucking awesome. And then she brought the mojito on the side to pour on top. Oh my god. That shit was fucking good. And then Diamond was doing some ham. Her mom's stuffing. God bless that woman. Oh, it was so good. And she did desserts, cupcakes. And the cupcakes were phenomenal. Like, they were so, oh my god, they were so good. And all right, so that was Diamond Daisy. Ooh, that's not on silent. Anyways, yeah, like that Diamond Daisy were in charge of that, and then Michael and Kat were in charge of mashed potatoes, chicken sliders, all gone. Oh, and sodas. He brought mad sodas. And then Aizen and his girl were in charge of yams and potato salad. Oh, the first when Aizen came through the door, the yams smelled amazing. Kudos, bro. You killed it. Yams was fucking good. And I hate yams. I think they're disgusting. I had a bite. It was good. That's all I did, though. Just a bite. I'm not a fan of yams. So, like, everyone thought they were good, though. So, my critique means nothing. I hate yams. Took a bite. It was good, but that was it. That's all. The mashed potatoes that your girl made, but not mashed potatoes, the potato salad. That shit was busting. That hit different. That was mad good. Whew. Then Jose fucking killed it with the penne, bro. Jose, and I was telling everybody Jose's gonna do penne. Everyone's like, what? But he did it. He got it done. The penne was fucking lit. It was so good. It was so good. But he said he boiled it in Corona for like an hour. I think he did. think he said an hour. Something like that. He boiled it in like Corona for an hour. And then what else was there? There was like the mac and cheese, there was gravy. Oh, Eisen also brought brownies, which are so good. The brownies are mad good and moist. Whoa, excuse me. And then after that, like, we all ate. We all said we were thankful for and stuff. And then we all ate, and then it was really good. We were so stuffed. Like, holy crap. Some of us had, like, seconds and thirds. Even took food home, and there were still fucking... I still have food here, bro. There's mad food here. Like, holy shit. Like, I ate one more plate the next day. On Sunday, just like a plate, and I was just like, "Bro, I'm fucking done. I'm not eating. There's only so much fucking Thanksgiving food. When Thanksgiving is 2 days away, 3 days away, that I can eat. Like, this is a dub. I'm done. Anyways, yeah, there's so much food here. There's so much food here, and it's like, bleh. I can only do so much, and then Thanksgiving is like right there, so I gotta eat more of that. Ugh. What else? And then we got into games. Yeah, we got into playing like a bunch of different. Hold on, let me like tilt this camera. There we go. We got into playing first this drinking game. My best friends made Daisy and Diamond. They made this infinite. All right, you know, if you've seen Doctor Strange, right? There's a scene at the end. Spoiler alert, I don't care if you haven't seen it. He faces Dormammu, who's this fucking entity being of all, and can destroy it. You can't kill him. So, no one knows how to kill him. There's no way. So, the way Dormammu does not perceive time. He's been alive so long, he doesn't know, like, time is nothing to him, basically. So, Doctor Strange is going to go fight with him, because Dormammu's about to eat the world, and he uses the Time Stone, and he does, like, this magic spell on, like he does, like, this weird thing on his wrist, and he does this magic spell. Anytime he dies, it reverses back in time, like, almost 30 seconds. So, either he does the spell first, and then he goes to Dormammu, and he's like, Dormammu, I've come to bargain. Gets killed. Turns back time. Dormammu, I've come to bargain. Gets killed. And it happens, like Doctor Strange gets killed, like, almost... The movie only had to show us, like 10 different ways he gets killed. But I'm assuming he's killed multiple, more than hundreds of ways. So Dormammu's like, what the fuck is going on? Dormammu starts having, like, deja vu. And he tells him, we're stuck in this infinite time loop until we struck a bargain where you fucking leave. That's what that drinking game was. You were stuck in an infinite loop of getting fucked up. They literally, it was a game that they made. And it was like shoots and ladders, kind of. But there's no ladders, just shoots. They forgot the ladder part. It was just nothing but shoots. Shooting you right back to the fucking beginning. And there was... one piece that made you go back twice to take a shot, and then there was a piece that made you go that reset you to the beginning. Here's the problem with that piece: four paces in front of that piece was another piece that sent you four paces back, and that four paces back was that spot that sent you back to the beginning. So basically, it was two spots that sent you to the beginning of the game, meaning you have to go through drinking again, you have to go through taking shots, doing this, doing that. And it was like, boy, what? Nonetheless, it was a great game. It was great. Of course, I've had a lot of Henny shots, and it was awesome, but damn. We played that, and then we went to, what did we go to next? Did we go to King's? Yeah, we did Kings. We did Kings for a little bit. While some people hit the Tarzan life, if you know what I'm talking about, you 420 friendly guys. We did Kings. It was me. We had fun in Kings, and then from Kings, we played a little game called Resistance. And let me tell you, Resistance is this crazy, manipulative spy game where you have to try to find the spies. Who's good? Who can I trust? Who can I not trust? Now, here's the thing. Me, Jose, and Aizen have been playing this game, three, 5 years now? We're veterans at it. We're pros. I just introduced the game to, like, Daisy, Diamond, Freddy, my brother and sister, like, on, the Halloween get-together I had. It was the first time they were introduced to it. Their logics are there, but it's not. So, this is, like, one of the rare moments we're seeing people outside of, like, the boys play the game. And it was so interesting because it's like, wow, is this what we sound like? Is this how we argue? And it was just good. We just let the chaos ensue. And that's what Resistance is all about. Just let the chaos introduce little anarchy. And that's what we let happen. It was just so funny watching. Was it Diamond and Daisy argued until the point where they flipped the card? And it was just like, now we got to start all over because you guys are revealing who you are to prove a point. Nobody cares. Like, it. And then the next round, my sister flipped the card because she didn't get to be a spy. And it's like, but now you can't do that because the next time if you get cards and you don't flip it, we know you're the spy. This is why you can't do that. So, anyways, Resistance was good for like the first 2-3 rounds. And then we had to stop. People were bugging. Like, boy. All right. And then, so then after Resistance, what did we go into? Did we go into? Oh, yeah. Again, you got 420 friendly real fast. And we started playing this game called Super Fight. Oh, God, that was such a good... That's another arguing game. I noticed me and the bros like playing arguing games. Like, we love it. It's just so good. We played Super Fight. I still think Superman can clap Thanos with a samurai sword. Easy. Simple. I don't give a shit. Anyways. But yeah, that, and then we like sit, we chat, we talked, we mingled. It was a really good time. It was Friendsgiving. It was a collective of like my friends together, new faces meeting new faces, and everybody had a good time. And it was a real good time. And then everyone slowly went home. I cleaned up. Surprisingly, I thought there was going to be a lot of cleanup. There really wasn't. It was just literally just packing the food away. And now I'm stuck with my food from Friendsgiving. And then I'm going to be stuck with more food for Thanksgiving. And I just don't want no more food here. It fucking sucks. Like, please leave now. Anyways, that was my Friendsgiving recap. It was really great. I love you guys all. Hope we can do this again real soon. But, like, with something else. Maybe, like, a Christmas... ugly Christmas sweater get together type of thing, but I don't want to host it because I hate cleaning that. Yeah, that. So that's my recap. See, told you, very short. I'm only on, I don't even know how many minutes this is. But future episodes, what you guys are coming to see next, hopefully, most likely. So this was Thanksgiving. Next week I'm trying to do a combination of like two episodes in one. It's going to be like me talking about Christmas and The Office, and hopefully I get my friend, like, I get her to, if she, that's happening if I can get if I get my friend to come on that episode. If I get her to come on it, and that's definitely what's happening. Christmas/office episode. The week after that, it not really a sex ed type of vibe thing, not even like a episode, but just talking about, not even like, it's like talking about sex, but like with partners. What do you feel about sex with this? It's not like a sex ed. Oh, you should wear condoms. You should use protection. But it's more of like, how do you feel about one night stands? This, that. It's more like, it's kind of like the relationship episode I had, but not like that, if you know what I'm saying. And then the episode after that is music. I'm doing the music one because everyone voted for, like, the music came in second, so I'm doing music. And then the episode after that, I think it might be New Year's. It might be New Year's. Or a recap of my birthday. Because my birthday is December 12th, but I don't know what I'm doing yet. Oh, I know I promised a vlog that was supposed to be in the beginning or end of this video. Not happening. I was so crazy busy the moment people started coming in. Like, I kept getting up, helping to do this, grab this, grab this, grab this. You need that, being a good host, that I forgot that I was going to do that. I didn't even take pictures. I took 2 videos for Snapchat. That's it. Too bad. I'll try to get a vlog of something else different. The Christmas office episode thing I'm gonna try to recreate something from the office, so it can be within the episode. But we'll see how it goes. I'll see what I can do. But those are like the future episodes of what I am trying to do and accomplish. I know people have been asking me now to do, what is it? Because I posted a Fortnite video, and they want me to do, like, I've had like a few people, like, because I have a few people who I game with that follow my Instagram for gaming and stuff, and they're gamers, and they want me to do more Fortnite videos. So I might do more Fortnite videos. Might even have an episode just dedicated on, not like, because I already did a gaming one, but one dedicated on, like, on talking about Fortnite, certain things in Fortnite. I'm probably gonna try to get somebody on for that, or I'll do it myself. It's fine. I don't care. And then I know people want me to do, I know he will hit me up to do, like, movie reviews and do this and like episode reviews. I could, but I would have to drop like 2 episodes a week, and that's too much. I still want to just keep it one shit a week. Like that. So I want to keep it like that for now. But yeah, that's everything soon to come. Hopefully I get better stuff when I get like better equipment and all that shit, and I'll talk about that. But for right now, that's what's soon to come. This was the shit of the week. Please like, share, subscribe, as usual, as you would usually do. It's been a fantastic time talking to all of you, and I'll miss you, and see you next time, weekly shit. Oh yeah, wait, let's end it with the Tory Lanez again. Hey, alright, I'm out. Peace. Deuces.